So the rule to remember here, ladies and gentlemen, is you got a bad board, don't worry about that. ICM will take care of you.
Time, timer flash 7 times, BTU system.
You ain't testing, you're guessing.
Hi, Peter. Good morning. It's Friday! And our second and final service call canceled.
Actually?
Yeah. Love me Fridays. Ladies and gentlemen, behind these two doors right here lies a furnace. Lies a furnace. And to all of my loyal viewers, you are going to recognize this. Yep. You're going to recognize this American Standard 80% gas-fired furnace. If you remember that White Rogers Emerson board we installed about 3 weeks ago. Yep, we sure did.
I was here? I don't think I was here.
No, I don't think you were here. And then I replaced the blower motor a week after that. It was very sus. It was very, very sus. It made that loud noise. And then, a week ago today, customer calls me. I'm in the pool, because it's Friday. Mm-hmm. It's 4:55, okay. Right? I'm in the pool. He calls, you know, left me a couple, I think called three times in a row. I was like, oh, it must be like a 911. Somebody call 911. Shorty fire burning on the dance floor. Right? Something like that. All right. And what do? I find that nothing's going on here. Absolutely nothing's going on here. Water's all over the floor. And I'm like, damn, what happened? Right? And I check for power. And I have power. Right? To my system. Right? My control is flashing. But nothing else is going on. Mm-hmm. So you know what I do? I take off the wire going from cool fan terminal on the control board, and I put it here, right? And the motor comes on. I was like, oh, I guess my motor's fine. I spent, Peter, because I wasn't testing, I was guessing, mm-hmm. because it was 5 o'clock, 5:20-ish when I was here, Friday afternoon. I'm in my bathing suit and a T-shirt and flip-flops, right? I kid you not, and there's a puddle of water here. So I'm basically staying here with, it was a mess. I spent 2 hours here.
Really?
Yeah. You know what happened? The transformer died. Mm. And my control board wasn't telling the fan to turn on. So I'm like, bro, I got you. Mm-hmm. So I left the fan like this, and I said, I'll see you next week. So now here we are. We are going to diagnose what's going on here. We have a new blower motor. We have a new transformer. And we have a new Emerson integrated furnace control. We need to see what's going on. You ready?
Ready.
Let's bang this horse. You hold the tail and I'll push it in. All right, so what we're going to do different this time than we did last time when I installed this board is we're actually going to use that Connect app. Okay. It wasn't working before because I had my door switch not taped down. So first thing I'm going to do is we're going to put back a crimp ring onto our line going to our blower motor. And I don't have the right size crimp ring or crimp terminal. So I'm going to put a larger size on. I just bent over the wiring. Going like that, nice and strong. I used to have a nice Nippix. Oh, was it a Nippix? We still have it probably. It was, yeah. Probably in the black abyss. So now we're going to take this wire and we're going to put it on our terminal for cool, which is right there. Okay. Don't worry about it dangling for right now. But there's our wire. Removed it from the 3-conductor Wago, leaving power our door switch to our control boards. Let's turn the switch back on. Okay, let's see what we have going on here. I have nothing going on in this control. Why not? Why is nothing going on in this control? That's odd. That door switch is open. Here's our power coming in. What the hell? Very, very odd. All right, so oddly enough, despite nothing being on this control board, right? The only thing we did different is that I took my blower motor from the Wago and I put it on the control board. And my control is not doing anything, but I had Peter go upstairs to the thermostat and lower it a couple degrees. And sure enough, we have communication between thermostat, control board, and outdoor unit. Turn power off. All right, that condenser stopped. So it looks like our control is bad, which is kind of sucks for Emerson, because this is a brand new single stage integrated furnace control. There it is, brand new. Right, but that's not illuminated. Crazy.
Did it get wet at all last week?
There was some moisture on it. And it was secured there. I took it off and it did work. It was illuminated. All right, I guess we're going to plan B. All right, plan B is going to be the ICM2812 kit. This is a universal hot surface igniter furnace control board that hopefully is going to be our solution and restore proper operation to this American Standard gas-fired furnace. Let's see what goes on. All right, so we're going to use the ICM2812 kit. Okay, we have our relatively brand new and dead Emerson White Rogers integrated furnace control, which obviously isn't integrating any furnace control anymore. I have my power switch off, and our door switch is taped, but first thing I'm going to do is verify that there's no power to the appliance. Let's turn it on. I like to use a non-contact tester. Others like to use actual voltmeter to confirm. I know the power's off. I know that switch is good, but you may want to double check with a proper multimeter. Peter's going to hold the camera. First thing we're going to do is just remove all of our wiring from the control. Now, I know exactly what each wire does because I've done this before a couple times. So you may want to take a picture of what you're taking off and what terminal you're taking it off from. Or you may want to remove the board from the furnace, affix the new one, and then one by one transfer wires over. One of the things you also want to do before you start messing around with all these wires is you want to just ground yourself. And the easiest way to ground yourself is just to touch something metal. Okay? Sometimes if you're walking out across a carpeted floor, you build up static and you touch something metal, you get that little spark. Well, imagine touching a brand new control and you spark that and it's dead. All right, so there we have that. All right, so I would like to clean this up a little bit. So we're going to move over to the transformer. We're going to take out this transformer just to give some more room to work with. So we moved the transformer over to the location of the original one. And now I secured the ICM2812 IFC board. Got that there smack in the center. Looks nice and pretty. I would have liked to put it this way, but it is what it is. We have some wiring things to take care of here. So first thing I'm going to do is start connecting wires step by step. Along the way, I also want to make sure that I'll be able to neaten this up a little bit because, listen, it's a bird's nest here of wiring, and let's do our best to clean this up and hope for the best. Hopefully everything works out well for us. All right, for almost all American Standard and Train models, you're going to use harness number 6, and you have to make a modification to it. The reason for that, because on there are two pins, and I believe it's pin number 11 and number 5, right, which is RO in and RO out on your factory harness, right? You notice that there's nothing there, 5 and 11, and that's RO in, RO out on your new control board. So you're going to take the ICM supplied harness number 6, and in a little bag that you're going to see like this, right, you're going to have a black wire that's labeled 10. Okay? See that? And you're going to have to remove the orange and the red wire from the harness that would plug into the new control. Remove those and install the jumper. Not recommended. You can also cut these two wires, right? And then with a Wago or a wire nut or a crimp tool, you know, make that connection solid. If you feel like being adventurous and you want to pull these wires out, well, good luck. You're going to have to really force this in there and try to get the barbs to push out, but it's a pain. It took us, I don't know, a good couple minutes to do this one. Equal amount of time to do this one. You could see how. But be careful not to damage the harness, because you have to put that in there. Okay, let's plug in that harness right there. Okay, we're also going to make sure our dip switch settings are both to 180 seconds or 150 seconds and one stage, because it's a single stage furnace. You also want to make sure you're utilizing the low speed tapping for heat. So take one of the wires that are on park and put it there. It doesn't matter which one it is, but you also want to do that as well. Okay, so we have these two, which are going nowhere. All right, so we can just cut these for now because they're not really doing anything. The blue wire is my flame sense wire. We're going to put that on there. And the only thing we have left to do is our low voltage control wire. In the interim, I just want to turn on power and see if anything happens. So far, so good. I can tell you this, that if you did not have the jumper wire, right, between 5 and 11, what's going to happen? Guys, all you HVAC pros out there know that if my rollout switch is open, right, we're going to have blower activation on power up because it's trying to clear that fault, that rollout. Okay, so we had some action going on right there. Now, let's tidy up our wires and then connect our low voltage connections. All right, so there is all of our control wiring. We did not do anything with low voltage yet. That's over here. We're going to work on that right now, but it looks much better than it did before, and you could still trace out things if need be. So let's just hook up our low voltage wiring. So out of the old harness, let's see. That was there. Okay. So it looks like blue is Y. Yeah, blue is Y. Just popped out of there, by the way. And so is our white. Okay, so this is going to our condenser because there's only two wires, right? Let's just cut that off right now. Okay, so this is our condenser. Okay, and this is going to be to our thermostat. So first thing, let's just clean this up a little bit, if possible. You hear a bird.
I see a bird too. Is it a parrot?
Yeah. Okay. So what were your wires we were doing?
You said the blue.
And the...
And I think it was the white.
Blue and the white. You think?
I think it was.
Okay. Sure?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You sure it wasn't the red? It was the blue and the red.
Was it? You pulled the white out right after the blue.
Did I?
Pretty sure.
So you think it's the red? You think it's the white?
Should we go back and review footage?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so we have our new ICM. The 2618, sorry, 2812 IFC. Integrated furnace control. And I think we did a good job with cleaning up the bird's nest of wiring that was here. All neat and organized. Peter, I think there's only one thing left to do.
I think so.
All right. I just heard my condenser kick on.
Got a red light.
I have a status light. And we have blower. Would you look at that?
Yes.
That is what we call TITS. All right, so now that we've confirmed blower and cooling activation,
We're not done yet. Now we're gonna go to the thermostat. We're gonna switch it from cool to heat, and we're gonna make sure this thing cycles in a heat cycle. That means we have hot surface ignition action, we have main ignition opening, we have flame proofing, and we have blower activation for heat. So let's go see what happens. Okay, I noticed a decrease of blower speed on our blower motor. Our inducer motor just kicked on. It definitely has seen better days. In a short amount of time, we're gonna see the hot surface igniter right there, which connected to this white harness. We're gonna see that glow. If it doesn't, well, maybe it got damaged, but let's see what's going on. All right, I heard a click, and there's our hot surface igniter. Make sure you wear your PPE when you're testing your equipment. You know, that thing shorts out, that thing blows up, it shatters, not good. I've never seen one shatter in person, but there's always a first. All right, we have main ignition. There's our burners. Okay, and we should have flame sensing by now, which we do. Excellent. Our inducer motor is on, our gas valve is energized, we have main ignition, and we have blower. There she is. Excellent, excellent job. And you know what? Huge shout out to ICM. By the way, ICM controls, they're located in New York State, in North Syracuse. All of their products are proudly made in the United States of America in their production plant in Syracuse, New York, which is upstate New York. They make controls for appliances, electrical, HVACR, marine, pool and spa, and recreational vehicles. They even got a cool little app. Check it out. You can on the Google Play Store or the App Store from Apple. Awesome, awesome little package right here. You can get this from Jackson Systems. You can get this from Johnstone. You can get this from supplyhouse.com or your favorite local HVACR distributor. Remember, the ICM 2812 is a universal hot surface control board that replaces the White Rogers and many, many more, over 150 competitive part numbers, right? You can download the app for full cross-reference information. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Save the day. Thanks, ICM.